VR show, which I'm sure many of you have heard about, the Crypto Jews of New Mexico.
Yes.
So I thought, oh, that's a great, you know, great topic. And so I went to, at that time, I went to New Mexico, but I was still a film student, and so I was, you know, not that seasoned. And I met with the producer of the NPR show, and he said, well, who are you? I mean, I have all these huge directors involved, you know, wanting to make a film about the topic. So I sort of met the people, but backed out, and then went on to complete film school and then did other projects. And then a few years ago, I decided that the crypto-Jewish dilemma, the conflict within themselves, you know, the being one thing from the inside and having to portray themselves another way on the outside, in the historical sense, was something that really still, you know, stimulated my interest. And so I came to Mexico, actually, to the Venta Prieta. I don't know if you've heard about the crypto Jews in outside of Mexico City. So I thought, oh well, maybe, you know, that would be my you know, venue into it. But the Venta Prieta Jews or crypto Jews or whatever you want to call them, they were not receptive at all to any outsiders. I think they had some bad experiences in the past. And so I went to the Tijuana Jews, and eventually what started as more of a historical film became about the rabbi Kukurkon called me and said, I'm going to Ecuador to convert these people. Would you like to come? Mm-hmm. And I said, oh, sounds good. I'll go. And when I actually arrived, I had no clue that there would be a conflict. I really thought that I was going to include this portion as a small portion within the larger film. And it was about some of those crypto Jews who are converting back to Judaism. But I wasn't really, I did not know anything about the conflict between the Jewish community and the crypto Jews. And so when I was faced with that myself, because I was trying to make a